Well, I met Texas Eddie down in Leon County at a place you call Norman G. Texas. They had a little old dude out there, what you call, I don't know, a picnic. And they had a ball game, see? Well, Norman G. was playing Leon. So that's the way they had him named. They didn't have a, you know, them that special big name like they got now, Colt 45 you know, they don't have them kind of names then, but they just the name of the town. So Leona Plain Norman G. So I got out there and I see the man up on the standing up on the truck with his hand up to his mouth and man, that man was singing. That was Texas, my cousin. I didn't know. All right. I goes on there, that man singing so, he just broke up, like he broke up the ball game. People paying so much attention to him instead of the ball game, see? That was interesting in him. While he had been gone, while all his people was in Norman G. Most of them, you know, his mother and them at that time was living, and he had been gone, kind of made a little straightaway like I did, and he stayed for a while, and he come back. That's the way he come back. You understand? He come back ready. I mean, he come back ready with that singing. He couldn't play no music. Never played an instrument in his life. But he towed a guitar. He'd buy a guitar. But he towed it in case that he'd run up on you or me or somebody could play, and he'd sing. And he kept a guitar because if he asked you, could you play a guitar? And you say, yeah, well, he got one, see? And then y'all tear it off. And that's when I met Texas Alexander many years ago in Norman G. Texas. Comes to him for quite a bit there in Crockett, Texas, and Grapeland, Palestine, Oakwood, and Buffalo, and Centerville, Norman G. Flynn, and Marquis, and back in them places. I never followed Texas no further than Houston for a long ways. Because he was a man who'd get up and go. First Cadillac that I ever known to be, you know, one of them Spencer's bad cars, he went somewhere and he come to Norman G. in a Cadillac, and that was the longest old ugly car, old long Cadillac, one of them first made, see? But it was new. That's, see, got over there, and everybody reminded him, you know, because a couple of people didn't have none. They didn't even have T-Mall fools then, you know. He come in a Cadillac. Hey, Texas was doing all right for himself. And he got singing them bad songs, I guess. He thought that it's all right. And, you know, in times you couldn't sing a bad song, you know. Not on the box and jukes and things. So he sung that bad song and sent him down, see. Some works on a cover like a bullhog's eye. Yeah, put him in a can for a while, but he sung on out of that. He got out. He wasn't in there too long. I don't think it was that too long. Cause he come back, but he knows better than to sing that kind of song again. But now, you know, they're singing everything, and and I did not condemn them. You know, I tell you what, now just like he said, I got something to tell you, baby, to make the hair rise on your head. I got something to give you, darling, to make your springs tremble on your bed. Them songs right that day is not as bad as they got now. They got these songs about what is that you got that makes, you know, a man do so much and this, that, and this, you know. And you understand, it's more ideas about it now. Because at that time, he was known, but everybody else didn't. But it just pulled the wool more wiser, see. It opened up my eyes, you know. I know what he's talking about now, but I didn't know then. I got something to give you, make the hair rise on your head. And then I got something to give. No, I got something to tell you. Make the hair rise on your head. Now, I got something to give you, make your springs tremble on your bed. Please, honest gentleman. Now it is, but I couldn't then. I didn't know what it meant. I'd have just been hollering it out for anybody. But now I know.